This was a movie that's been on my watch list for quite a while. Critics were praising it, some audiences were too, and so because of that, I decided to check it out for myself. My hopes were high, but unfortunately, it didn't do it for me. I will get to what I liked about it. The cinematography is actually spot on for something that's meant to be a documentary-style filmmaking. Also, I thought the concept for this movie was admittedly kind of interesting. My problem with it is I don't think it should have been made into a movie that people had to pay to see. Why is that? Well, I didn't really like anything else. I didn't find this movie scary at all, in spite of me going into this one blind. If anything, this movie bored me. Despite the movie being only 81 minutes, it felt really dragged out, as if there weren't any many interesting parts in this movie. The fact that it had no soundtrack at all didn't help either. I am aware it's like that to be realistic, but still. In fact, it felt like a 2 to 3 hour movie despite its short length, and most of the movie was focused on three teenagers pissing about in the woods looking for a witch. And talking of the teenagers, their characters and their acting I could not stand. Josh and Mike were just cocky jerks who weren't the slightest bit funny. The only time I even laughed or had some entertainment value was when they gave some ridiculous deliveries, but even then I wasn't sure how to feel about that since the movie wasn't meant to be funny in the first place. But now we go on to one of the worst parts of this movie, Heather. Not only was she the one who decided it was a good idea to go out into the woods and risk her friend's health and safety over filming a documentary about the Blair Witch, but her acting. Dear sweet Jesus and our Sonic the Hedgehog ice cream, it was abysmal. When she isn't sounding boring, she had such awful deliveries, especially when she gets mad or sad. I swear, I never really could sympathize with her because of how annoying she was, and it's honestly the worst character to me. Honestly, she deserved her Razzie. Maybe it might be because I'm not into found footage movies, but still, I don't mind horror movies, nor do I mind documentaries, but at least give me some substance to chew on. I feel like it would have been impressive in 1999, but in 2021, it's definitely pretty bad. Honestly, I consider this movie very overrated, and it's a shame because I was legitimately interested in seeing it initially. If I was feeling generous, I would give this movie a 2 or even a 2.5 out of 5. But I'm not really feeling generous now, so unfortunately, this is getting a 1.5. If you like it, that's fantastic. I'm not trying to spoil your fun, but yeah, for me at least, I thought this movie kind of sucked.